But I thought I would show you guys a wonderful segment called The Internet Loves This Segment.
All right, so we're going to try to do a little scent training for the banana. Are you ready?
Friends, how are we doing today? How are we, Tyler?
Hi.
Hi. So, kind of a late start to the morning. I've literally laid in my bed and done nothing, except take the dogs out a couple of times.
I've laid in my bed and done nothing until the work called.
Yep. Work has asked for him to come in, and he was like, yeah. And then mom called the lady that he works with. Like his boss or something? Is that who Laura is?
She's my supervisor.
Yeah, his supervisor, her car broke down. So she...
Copier broke down.
I thought it was car. Oh, well. But she is supposed to call whenever Tyler could come into work. So where are we going in the meantime?
Panda.
Panda, one of our most favorite places. And then I need to get gas. And at some point, I think I may get my car washed. Because it has lovely essence of dog in my car. Walmart even said, there's interior stains in your car. Well, that's because I have dogs. And I got to do some exposure training with MRL today. The people from the power company are out messing with lights. So I got to have MRL stand near their trucks and watch them as they made weird noises. So, yay! Dog training for the day! Though we may do a little more later, I don't know. So, I want to tell you good morning. Check back in with you later. So, hey guys. We're at Torture World, aka Walmart. My brother's looking for something right now. But I thought I would show you guys a wonderful segment called The Internet Loves This Section. So, here we go. This is the Internet Loves This section. There's Littlest Pet Shop. Of course, Shopkins, which everybody loves for some reason. I've never understood why. Because it's like, look, it's little grocery things with faces. Wouldn't it be kind of weird? Like, sitting on the toilet and your mop is watching you. That's weird. That's weird, bro. And then, the Tsum-Tsums. The Tsum-Tsums are a huge thing. You can get a really weird octopus. And Stitch is pretty cool. And of course, My Little Pony. But this isn't all of the Internet Loves This section. On the other side is the Internet Loves It Part 2. Here's Part 2 of the Internet Loves This. There's these My Mini Mixie Cues. I mean, they're so freaking small. I don't understand why people like them. You would lose these really easy. And then there's, I guess that's new. It's called Giftums. I don't know. I haven't seen those on the internet as of yet. There's Toozies. The internet freaking loves these. And when I say the internet, I'm usually meaning like those people who unbox toys on TV. Not on TV, on the internet. And you're like, how do they have the money for this? Oh, look, more Shopkins. There's these Num Nom things. I don't understand why people like these. Oh, and there's these, like, squinky dewdrops. Like, you get, like, a little animal and a hairdo inside. And I kind of don't understand the point of it. Look, there they are. They're, like, really freaking small. And there's, like, those LOL surprise dolls. But they kind of seem like they would be pretty big. Like, that seems like a pretty decent size for a toy. But not for that price. But... $10 for this? No. Okay, and here's the last part of the Internet Loves This Part 3. Apparently there's not much of these left anymore, so they must be pretty popular. These things. There's Kitty in my pocket, and there's puppies. They're like these little fuzzy toy things. And they're cute, but not for the price. That's what I don't understand, how people can just like unbox a bunch of these toys. It's like, do you realize how much these are? Like these, just for this is like $5.97. These are like $3 each, and you see people like 6 or 7 of them. So that's like, you could spend a whole paycheck just on material for your YouTube channel. And I'm not making fun of the YouTube channels that do this, I promise. It's just, I don't understand it. Ooh, bonus! This is not from the internet, love this, but it looks cute. Can I get it to work? Aw, oh, he's so cute! Okay, look, this dog, Bailey, he... See, he's already really good at settle. Look at that settle. Alright, speak! There you go. And a tail is already a weapon of mass destruction. So there you go. There's the end of The Internet Loves This with a bonus dog.
Alright, so we're going to try to do a little scent training for the banana. Are you ready? Can you alert? Alert? No, you gotta alert. Alert? Can you alert? Alert? Yes! Good boy! And today's treat is going to be banana. Yeah, is that good? Back up. Back up. Alert. No. What do you do? Alert. Yes! Good boy! And there's him a piece of banana, because we learned he really likes bananas. Give Riddler a piece too. All right. Now I'm gonna make this a little more challenging, okay? I've got sample jar, and I've got the wet jar. Well, hold on. Sample jar and a jar with just water. He has to figure out which one has the scent. And he has to alert me. Right, bud? Alert? Which one is it? Nope, that's not it. Sniff it, find it. Sniff it, sniff it. Can you sniff it? Sniff it, find it. Which one is it? Alert. Buddy. Can you sniff it, find it? No. Uh-oh. Which one is it? Here, we'll move this one. I might also be covering in a banana. Ow! I just hit my elbow. Come here. Snip it. Flapper. Come here. Alert. Nope. Alert. 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 No. Alert. 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 Puppy. Alert. Alert. There you go. Good boy. And I know I just showed it for him, but it helps him to figure out that this is what he has to do. Okay, new area because he was getting distracted by Riddler. Stay. All right. Now you have to figure out, you have to know how to, when to alert so you can get the banana. Ready? Alert. Sniff it. Yes, good boy. There you go. Wipe off your mouth. All right. No, sir. No. Over here. Yes. All right, bud. Sniff it. Can you sniff? Sniff. Sniff. Can you alert? No. Do you alert? No? Good boy. What about this one? Do you alert? All right, I want to move these. Sniff it. Sniff it. Ow, you're digging into my finger, no toe. Yes! Good boy! Yay! Sniff it. Back up. Sniff it. Sniff it. Buddy, you have to actually smell these. No. I know, you can respond to tapping. You have to actually smell it. Sniff. Good boy. Good sniff. Sniff. Yes, good boy. Good sniff. Good sniff. Sniff. Nope. Sniff. No. Sniff. Hey guys! I know my hair is pretty darn wild because it was under a beanie most of the day.
So there's my sweet little fluff butt. Hey baby boy. I love you. And there's my two other doggies, Miss Sassy and Mr. Riddler.
So after the scent training, I didn't really update you guys, and I should have. I'm sorry. So Of course, part of me wants to edit out the scent training because it didn't go exactly how I wanted it to. But I also want to show that, you know, training is not always perfect. But what we got out of this imperfect training session is what did go wrong and how we could fix it. Or at least figure out a way to fix it. So with MRL, one thing I kept noticing is he kept alerting when he had a jar. Just a jar in front of his face. Because I had two that had gauze pads soaked in water. And one that had my saliva. And though he was good at figuring out the jar that had the saliva, I think he just kept alerting when there was a jar. And I think at the time it also didn't help that I had given him a new treat of bananas. So he was even more excited because he was like, ooh, new treat. So probably not the best to do that right at training. Maybe give him the treat and then train a little later or something. I don't know. But now it gives me an idea to stuff his Kong with, like, I've heard of like a doggy ice cream, which is like peanut butter and banana mixed together, and that the dogs would freaking love it. But I wish I had two Kong toys so that both boys could have one and they won't fight over one of them. Because I know Riddler gets super possessive over the Kong if it has peanut butter in it, which is why I don't put peanut butter in it very often. Let's see, for the rest of the day, what happened? Cleaned the kitchen. That was fun. Not really. I don't really like cleaning the kitchen. I got the vlog worked on. I got old vlogs, stuff like cleared, and I got my external hard drive filled with vlogs, so we're good. I found old footage of MRL as a baby, and it was so cute. If you guys want to, give me a thumbs up if you would like to see some of those old clips of MRL when he was like a baby. I mean, I can find a picture of him as a newborn puppy. But, like, obviously my footage starts with him at 7 weeks old. And then has him at this, our lovely almost 6 month old. He'll be 6 months old, like, I think next Monday? You'll be 6 months? Yeah? Yeah. And then what else did I do? My brother and I did another poppin' cookin' kit. It was one called Purin Parfait, which Purin, I guess, is kind of like a Japanese pudding. I didn't like it. And then there was pizza. And then Mom and I, we watched some TV together. And we watched some bloopers from Big Bang Theory. And then I came back upstairs. I needed to do homework. I just wrote out a procedures list for a project. And got that sent. And then was just playing on my phone. That has been my day, really. I do want to try to put in more training videos. If I can. Like showing MRL training. But, I mean, we'll see what we could do. Got lots of training done today. And, of course, we worked on space. Which means back up. As I think I've said it already. But now I'm going to sign off for the night and head off to bed. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you've had a wonderful day or night, rain or shine, whatever the world has for you today. Question of the day. So I showed you guys different toys today that I feel like the internet likes. Or that I've seen a lot of like toy guru type people open and whatever. What is your favorite toy? Like, it could be a toy from now or like from when you were a kid or whatever. So for me, my favorite toy currently would be, if I can grab him, my stuffed Rapidash Cheeto. Because Rapidash is my most favorite Pokemon ever. The second would definitely be Stevie Wonder, the llama. And then of course my Funko Pops. So put your answers down below and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!
Good night, my little fluff butt. Good night, Sassafrasum. Good night, Riddler. Sweet dreams!